What's up, everyone? Welcome to my channel again. And today we're going to change the battery of this car. Well, the battery is totally dead because one day after I charge the battery, it still can't start. And the battery is only producing something like 6 volt something, which is not 12 volt, which is not healthy. So it is very obvious that the battery is dead ready and I need a replacement for the battery. Well, pretty good for a battery that can last for almost 3 years. So let me show you the voltage of the battery. Definitely not 12 volt, it's only 4 volts. So I think for the most part of the video, I'll just sit inside the car because it is too hot outside. I mean, it is Malaysia, it's supposed to be hot, and we all don't like it. So as we can see, after we check the battery, it's only producing something like 4 volts, which is definitely not enough for starting the car because it requires 12 volts. So it's like last time, I'm going to access the boot and then I take my jumper, jump the car with the Cantio and then off to Proton. And also I did an appointment today, so see you in a minute. So I just jump start the car and I take my mask and off we go to the service center. So let's do some Q&A that you all guys sent me when I asked about the question and answer in my Instagram. Okay, first, why do the battery dead? Well, there are two main reasons why is the battery dead. One of it is you rarely start your car and your battery just flat out by the alarm or the system that runs in your car. Your battery just run flat and you need to charge your battery. So if that's the case, you just need to jump start the car and charge it for a few minutes. It should be good to go. And the other reason is it's time for you to change the battery. That's my case. Normally a car battery will last for like 2 years or more, near to 3 years. And my battery happens to be 2 years and 11 months to be precise. So it is actually the time to change the battery. I just waiting for the battery to flat, and now it flats. Well, if that's the case, then you need to change the battery. And next, how to know the battery is healthy? Well, if your car is switched off, your battery should be producing a healthy 12 volt. I mean more than 12 volt. And then if your car is running, like your engine is running, the battery should be producing a 14 volts or something, more than 12 volts. It indicates that the battery is being charged. And how do you measure it? Good question. You just use your multimeter or the voltmeter, just point the red to the positive, the black to the negative, and then you read the value. That's it. And next, is it really safe to jump start your car? Well, let me tell you, it is safe. Last time there was a rumor about you might harm your car if you're trying to jump start the engine. Well, that thing is wrong. Well, that statement is proved to be wrong because In the owner's manual, which all of us should follow the owner's manual, it states that if your battery is flat, there are two things you can do. Either one, One of it is called the Proton, and they will come and settle the thing for you. And do they charge money on that? I don't know, but that's a way. And the other way is jumpstart the car. It literally says jumpstart the car, but of course with a correct procedure, which I show you in the previous video. So it is actually nothing harm if you jumpstart the car. And how about pushing a car, push start a car? I mean, some of the older car, especially manual car, you just need to push the car, press the clutch, you push the car. When you get to a certain speed, you just release the clutch, and then the wheel will crank the engine and the engine will start. Well, can you start the car like that? Well, actually you can, but you don't. Because in modern car, there's a lot of ECU, a lot of computer stuff. And if you try to start the engine with rotating the wheels, well, there is some chance that your ECU may damage. So it is better that you don't push the car unless your car doesn't have any ECU system, like the Kanchio. So I'm actually reaching the Proton Service Center, and I got my mask here. So they'll do the replacement of battery, and I'll see you in a minute. Well, I just done replacing the battery. I do it in the Proton Service Center because, well, I compare the price, it costs the same as doing it outside. So it is way more convenient to do it at Proton Service Center, since they will clear the ECU, error code for you. And if you do it outside, you still need to come back to Proton Service Center just to clear the check engine light. So unless it is really very cheap, then I'll consider doing it outside shops. And plus, during this MCO time, a lot of shop is not opening, so there's not a lot of choice to make. And I guess that's it for today. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.